I have become stronger.
Yourself. Much better. Thank you.
Focus your attack.
Okay.
Beast of Blood, as you know. Ancient Sacrifice to me!
No escape.
Manifest yourself. So this is the legendary Monolith.
Not good
enough. Sure. Oh, nice call. Go on, she's anywhere.
Everyone, let's go!
Come
on,
I can do it!
Let's
edge! Please
delete Keen. Heal Kaboom! Summon!
Melia, cheer up!
I feel the ether. Building within me.
Healing!
Ice to me! Manifest yourself!
We can definitely do this!
Almost there! Manifest yourself!
This will be fun!
Flawless victory! Keno could have knocked that one out!
Nice job!
Prepare yourselves!
Everyone! Do your best!
Witness true power!
I see.
Roaring! mine!
We can definitely do this!
Witness my true power! Manifest yourself! Take me lightly at your peril! I will use my power to protect my friends! Approach my limit.
Ah, it's just scratch. Even a very big scratch.
Now you shall witness our power.
Witness true power of hero pawn in training.
Everyone, do your best.
Manifest yourself. Succumb to the power.
We can definitely do this.
Thank you. How many times have I told you, you do not go there alone?
But I really needed that material.
Doesn't matter. Why did you disobey me? If something happened to you, we would lose everything.
Tyrea?
Melia?
Huh? Wait a second. You know Melia, big sis?
Tyrea's your big sis.
Right. That explains how you came to the capital just in time to save Teelan's skin.
Sorry.
Sorry for the trouble. Truly. Although I am glad you were there.
Yeah, you really helped me out, Shulk, Miss Melia. And you too, Kino, Nene.
Tyrea. I didn't expect to see you here, helping Teelan with his research.
Yes, well.
Tyrea, she's changed.
Teelan, I'm going outside for a bit to get some air.
Got it. I didn't know you all knew Big Sis Tyrea. How'd you meet each other?
Well, that's because Tyrea and I share an older brother.
Huh? Does that mean you and her are sisters then?
Sisters? No. It's rather more complicated. But sisters, we are not.
Well, still, that means you know her from way back. What was she like?
Hmm?
I've only known her here, in this place, so I gotta wonder how she was before.
She was... She was strong, both in body and in her conviction for doing what she thought was right.
Wow! Pretty much the same as how she is now, then. When it comes to our research, she's even more committed than I am.
So she has not forgotten her mother.
Where did you and Tyrea meet?
It was when she saved me from the Fog King.
On a trip to Alchemoth, like today.
What? No. At the time, everyone was still living there.
Before the Fog King showed up?
Yeah, and then after we all escaped, I was kind of on my own, so Tyrea brought me here for safety.
One moment. Teelan, was your father not still around?
My father was killed by the Fog King.
Is that so? I'm sorry.
Teelan, just like Kino. Brave little pun.
I think I'll get some air too.
Go ahead. I've still got things to ask Teelan, so I'll stay with him.
Good, thank you. Shan't be long.
Miss Melly, Kino go too.
Kino, please read room.
Tyrea.
Of all the people to meet out here,
how did you?
Pure chance. After everything, I wandered aimlessly looking for somewhere to die. Then, at some point, I landed here.
So then, you were here all along?
That's right. And so, when the capital fell here, I thought Mother had finally granted me my boon.
But it was full of Telethia, and survivors cast adrift. Not to mention this Fog King.
Yes. He'd be the one to end it. Or so I thought. Until fate had me save Teelan, and death ceased to be an option.
Your mother, she did not grant you a dying place. She gave you our future by crossing your path with Teelan's.
My helping with Teelan's research is a simple matter of give and take.
If you really believed that, you would not have treated him half so warmly. I can tell that when you look at Teelan, you see family. Even if it was once transactional, his research concerns the future of our race. That fact remains.
The future of the High Entia, huh? And what about you?
Me?
You must have heard. Our brethren in this land are suffering.
Yes.
You are the Imperial successor. The Crown Princess, war or no war? No. Empress now. What will you do about the future of our race?
I have not planned that far ahead. However, I know enough to realize what I must do right now.
I hope to see it. This future you will build for us. And when I do, I hope I'll be able to accept what I now am.
Empress Melia, so you are ready to lead us after all. It shall be my privilege to clear the stones from your path.
Did you learn anything from Teelan?
A little. He said that for all the details, we ought to talk to Radzum in Grandel.
Meeting should be no problem. Teelan say he send word to guard a Grandel ramparts to let friends through.
Before we visit this Radzum, I have something I wish to discuss with you all.
What is matter now?
The High Entia who live here now have lost all hope for the future. I have a duty. As the Imperial successor, I must safeguard their future. This will sound selfish, I know, but will you stand with me?
Of course I will, Melia.
Kino, too. And also Nene.
Thank you. It means a lot to me. Right. Off to Grandel we go.
Thank you.
Miss Tyrea seem like difficult sort of person to deal with.
Difficult, huh? Maybe so, but she's still far more mellow than before.
Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea know each other from where?
Well, it's a little complicated to explain.
Complicated? How?
I'm just not quite sure where to begin. For one, Tyrea and I had never met until 1 year ago.
Houses too far apart, or...?
I was not allowed to venture outside. Moreover, I never even knew of her existence. She, on the other hand, seemed to know about me. We never met because work had been busy.
But how Miss Melia never know her? If sisters, then of course she'd know.
That's true. How can I explain this? Tyrea and I have separate parents. Different fathers and different mothers, both.
Meme! In same boat as Nene and Kino, then!
Just like you and Kino, Tyrea and I are not related by blood. But we had a half-brother with whom we shared a parent each.
Half-brother?
No parents in common, but a brother we are both related to. Therefore, Tyrea and I are not exactly complete strangers.
Me! Brain of Nene's starting to melt!
I'm sorry. I did say it's complicated.
Nene does not understand. If both have same brother, why cannot be one family together?
Our parents being different, I and Tyrea have led very different lives. We never even met, let alone behaved as a family. Neither knows how to relate to the other, and so we struggle on.
It sounds like Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea both feeling more like Kino.
How do you mean?
Kino also not talk to anyone at first. Very Heidi shy.
I don't think I'd call myself or Tyrea shy, exactly.
If want to become good friends, but not know how to put in action, then it's exactly same. But as can see for self, now Nene and Kino super best of friends.
Do tell, how did you two achieve that? Would you teach me the way, please?
Answer is clear as day. Nene prescribed lots of play-play.
Play-play?
Also, sharing of yummy snacks and sleep together in same bed. If do that, become family in wink of eye.
I'm not sure I can do that with Tyrea. Seems like a lot.
Meh! Nene, patience is exhaust! Miss Melia want to be sisters with Miss Tyrea or not?
Yes. I would really like that, I think.
So, now is best and only chance. No time for hemmings and hawrings.
Best and only? Perhaps you're right.
Okay, then now Miss Melia go and say, "Hey, Sister Bon, come play."
Right now? I need some time to compose myself.
Oh, if Miss Melia must, but have to promise to ask soon.
Yes, I will. One day very soon.
Manifest,
you're angry!
Let's rush for the kill.
Stop sharing flames of isolation.
Okay, let's finish this.
Witness my true power.
Look alive!
Battle
stars! How that? We beat enemies fair and square.
No enemy can stand against us when we bring our might to bear.
That's because you're both pretty sturdily built.
Huh?
Yeah?
Huh? Why the cold stairs? Wait, is there an enemy behind me?
Witness my true power!
Battle Soul!
Alright, I'm
doing it! Star-searing flames of absolution!
We can definitely do this!
This will make a mark!
Impulse! Glowing through me!
Backslash!
Sword copy! We are victorious!
Nice job!
Have to practice that upon once Nene get back!
Thank you.
Greetings. We have heard from Teelan that a man called Radzim lives within these walls.
Ah, friends of Teelan's, are you? We've been expecting you. Go on, in you get.
You're letting us straight through.
You don't look particularly concerning, is all. These walls are imposing, but they aren't here for controlling foot traffic. They're to keep savage monsters from having themselves a rampage.
Most sensible. Well, we'll be going then.
Bye, Kings! Sorry for time taking.
Hi there.
Thank you. else.
One just want nap. Thank you.
What splendid armor! Oh, it's true! Scales so shiny and sparkly!
It looks the same as any Armu, if you ask me.
Different subtle.
Sure is.
Really?
Pardon me. Have you come from Companion's Cape, by any chance?
We've just come from the laboratory. But we were at the Cape just before that.
And was everyone there all right?
Yes, it seemed to me.
Thank goodness. That's a relief to hear.
Is something wrong?
You may be aware, but originally, we all lived here together, as a group.
But then, some left because there are Machina here.
Exactly. At first, we managed to tolerate each other in relative harmony. Obviously, we had our share of friction.
What happened?
Well, the final straw was something trivial. The Companions tried all sorts of ploys to retake the capital, but none of the plans succeeded. Many soldiers were lost this way. One Machina had had enough and told them to just give up.
And that's when it happened.
Yeah. They shouted, "If you rust rats hadn't betrayed us, we wouldn't have lost our brethren and our homes in the first place." Things got heated, and then they left and didn't look back.
They shouldn't have forgotten that we all lost friends, family, and homes.
They're soldiers, ma'am. In the war, they put everything on the line for their country. And so,
when their country was taken from them, the extent of their anger and resentment was fully understandable.
Yes. Still, we who stayed behind don't bear them any grudges. They protected us all, for a long time, regardless of race. And bear in mind, in the end, they didn't cast the Machina out. They left the safety of our walls of their own volition. That's why we pledged that if they chose to return, we'd welcome them back and meet them with a smile.
I will do whatever is in my power to make it so.
Day-day, my eyes sweating. Inflammation of tear ducts.
By the way, we have heard that someone by the name of Radzim lives here.
Radzim? Yes, he lives over there.
Over there? Thank you. Very kind.
It was Radzim, actually. He was the one who told the Companions to give up their quest.
Right. I see.
All right. Let's go and see him straight away.
Yes, let's. Are you perchance Radzim?
Yeah, that's me. How do you know my name?
Teelan mentioned you. You are his fellow researcher.
Oh, I see. Teelan sent you. Him and Tyrea still getting on okay?
Quite. Though she did give him a good scolding earlier.
Went to Alchemoth again, did he? I did warn him not to be reckless. But when it comes to his research, that boy has tunnel vision. To be honest, so does Tyrea.
Does she come here much as well?
No, hardly ever. She's even more focused on the work than Teelan. I couldn't begin to guess why she's so driven.
It must be about her mother after all.
Radzum, we have questions. About the Fog King.
I see. That's why you're so curious.
We need more to go on. What can you tell us?
Because of the Telethia's ether field, the Fog King and his Fog Beasts seem, well, unable to escape Alchemoth.
Ether field?
Yeah. It's the means by which Telethia eliminate any excess ether that they absorb. Now, the Fog King and his beasts happen to give off an awful lot of ether.
I see. So all Telethia in the vicinity flock there, to feed on the ether, and, as a result, keep the threat contained.
Oh, this hot noggin of Kino. It get worse if not shut up.
But my ether, it worked against Fog Beasts, but not the Fog King. Or rather, it didn't even seem to make direct contact with him.
Shulk, Melia? Would you do me a favor and head to Teelin's lab, borrow his Telethia research notes for me?
Sure, we can do that for you.
There's something I'd like to look up about the Telethia's ether field.
Understood.
On another note, we heard that you spoke out against the Companions.
I voiced an opinion, yes. I can understand their impatience. Their ancestral home was right there. However, I couldn't abide watching them throw away more lives for nothing.
Nothing. Sounds quite stark.
At first, there were hundreds of us living here. But now? Well, you've seen for yourselves.
And all because of the Fog King.
Yeah. So I think you can see why I said what I said. If we end up extinct, we'll have won nothing.
Well spoken. But I'm sure the Companions would find those words hard to swallow. I'm sorry. Your people are no more free to go home than we are.
No need for you to apologize, Melia. In truth, it's not costing me any sleep. They seem to be catching on too. After all, they've stayed put since then.
When you put it like that... The people of Grandel, they're living under considerable strain, not knowing what became of their homes, and with no means of return.
Hmm. But that's also true of Maxis. His people lost their homes too.
Yes. But they're feeling desperate, and it's making them unreasonable.
It too sad.
We were like that too once, weren't we?
Yes, we were.
That true?
Hmm. But we learned, eventually. All because we wanted to protect the world. And we made that dream a reality. We brought down Zanza.
Overcoming our prejudice gave us strength in unity, because we shared a goal.
Radzum's folk, the Companions, and us as well. We all share the same goal.
Defeating the Fog King and returning home.
Hmm.
Sounds like job for Hero Punkino. Just let Nene at him.
Thank you, everyone.
Mamma me, what that thing?
Is that...
It's like the one we saw in Alchemoth, but much, much larger.
You're right.
Shulk, let's see if we can get closer.
Yeah,
All right.
What is happening over there?
Fog.
Huh?
frog beasts.
Here they come!
No time for deliberations. Let's go, Shulk.
Got it!
Shulk, the fog beasts were meant to be confined within Alchemoth.
I don't think that's where those ones came from.
What do you mean?
The rift made normal monsters transform into fog beasts.
Grandel!
Ah!
What is matter?
The Armus could turn into fog beasts.
Meh, meh! No one to picture that! Must hurry to rescue!
Instinct was right, Melia.
Yes, although the rift's influence is spreading far too quickly. Radson, are you fine?
Miss Melia, these armors, it was so sudden.
You can explain later. Let us do the fighting here. You should seek refuge.
Right you are.
Thank you for that.
Was everyone all right?
Yeah. No major injuries to speak of. All thanks to you, of course.
Kino accepts your supply of sweet wasabi as reward. Real hereupon never has compensation. Where it say that?
Shulk, was it the rift's expanding influence that's responsible for our Armu's transformation?
Looks like it. We saw it happen before, too. Regular monsters turned into fog beasts, just like that.
That suggests more fog beasts will appear if the rift continues to spread its vileness. Consider, with the size it was before, the rift's effect was limited to the area within the capital. But now it's getting wider.
One moment. In that case, if the rift keeps growing larger...
All monsters everywhere could be changed by the fog.
We must find a way to fight back.
We'll need those research notes for that. Let's head for the lab.
Right.
Thank you. All right.
Huh?
Villain! What do you want?
You stand in the way of a new age dawning.
Sis, I'm scared.
It's all right. I'll protect you and our work, I swear.
Behold, the widening rift in the sky. It's proof definite the world abhors you.
Spare me your ravings.
Oh, Lady Melia, the hope of our race.
Gelgar, what is this treachery?
As you can see, I am sweeping away some pebbles. Their research is blasphemy against the commingled blood.
Don't you comprehend the import of what you're interrupting? The very future of our race hinges on their work.
You think this is the future? This reactionary struggle to revive what is long buried? The future of the Hyentia is us. We are what the race ought to become. We are the true face of the Hyentia.
If not for our ancestors, we would never even have drawn breath.
Ancestors? I recognize them not. You, Lady Melia, are our progenitor. You were our beginning, and you will be our future.
Senseless drivel. If you would interfere with this research for the sake of spouting your nonsense, you do not deserve my mercy.
Melia.
Why won't you understand? Why won't you accept that we are the ones destined to lead?
You will not so easily refute our history.
So be it. I reject you. I will take the mantle and become father of our kin. I will take dominion over all.
Summon.
And the world will be set to rights. Know your place, whelps. Take dominion over all, and the world will be set to rights.
All right, I'm feeling it.
Pure blood, that's what they deserve.
Know your place.
Well, we can definitely do this. This is the Monado's power.
I feel the ether building within me.
You think you know my mind? You know nothing!
We can definitely do this! This is the Monado's power!
This isn't going well!
Light is on my side!
This isn't going well! Let's
know your
place!
Not good enough!
What is cool?
Go!
There is
crash! Everyone! Let's go! We can definitely do this!
I know I am not wrong. I'm not.
I will spare you. Just be gone from my sight.
No! The lab! Melia! Miss Melia!
No! Idiots!
The crown is mine now.
Talon!
Vixis, help!
Better safe than sorry. The pure blood meets its end today.
Are you okay, Talon?
Talethia, here! Damn!
She's okay. She's all right.
I'm sorry. I couldn't save. The future.